Hey, lovely people, welcome back. Today I wanted to talk a little bit about the importance of not ignoring those early signs when you think something is wrong. I'm Dr. Sally Bell, for those that don't know me. I'm a medical doctor and have an interest in root cause medicine, working out what's going on in your body, trusting that your body is designed for health and healing, and how do we live in a way that can help us heal and feel good. I've been exploring over the last two or three videos this idea of how the body is genetically wired for our flourishing, to feel good, to thrive. And I've explored a little bit about how it does that and how it reads all this information and where it gets that information from and how there's this constant feedback within our body and changes going on to help us flourish and feel good. And last week I touched a little bit also just on our emotions as signposts, pointing to the deeper issues within us, often giving us incredible amount of wisdom to know what we need for living healthy lives that flourish and where we can enjoy ourselves. And I wanted to make mention of the importance of picking up and trusting those early signs when you know something's not right in your body. This is being recorded in 2022, and I'm based in the UK, and sadly we've got figures coming out about the state of our health service where there is a lot of delay around picking up diagnoses, especially in things like cancer, as well as delay to treatment. And that is a complicated problem to do with our services and access to services. But I think even in the most perfect service, the way we're trained in modern medicine really doesn't give scope to pick up on those early signs of disease. And we are very much trained to listen to your symptoms and your story and pick up signs when we're examining you and put that together, put you into a disease category, and then on the whole, you know, follow guidelines that are given to us from above. That often are pharmaceutically driven to treat that particular disease that you are struggling with. And it doesn't leave room for treating you. It's all about treating diseases. And I think the problem also with this idea is that it almost assumes that your diagnoses or illness suddenly just falls out of the sky. Like one day you just have cancer, one day you have diabetes, one day I've got obesity or depression. And you know, certainly as a family doctor, and I know many doctors within the community are far more aware of this, that patients present a long time before they fit into any disease category. And we know from the science that there is a process to disease. Like our everyday decisions are impacting that process towards health or towards manifesting a disease. Something like cancer, we're now understanding that it can be decades, you know, beforehand of these tiny damages to our DNA before we get a particular type of cancer. And the same like with diabetes, you know, a whole host of things goes wrong first before finally we say your sugars are at a particular point that makes you fit a diabetic criteria. And it goes on and on. And so there is a problem in how we're trained. And then obviously, you know, there's a problem around access for care where, you know, we are a disease management service and not necessarily a health promotion service. And, you know, getting in for your 10 minutes, you know, with a doctor, you know, and trying to articulate your story and getting to the bottom of what's going on. There's just not enough time. And then because of the degradation of continuity of care that we've seen over the last couple of decades, it's not even if you can pick up with that patient or you pick up with that doctor again in a few weeks' time and you build a picture of what's going on. You know, we haven't got that anymore, sadly. And so that leaves us as patients, because I'm a patient too, and it leaves us with the problem because there's so many times over my decades of working, I hear patients say to me, I know something's wrong. I know you're telling me the bloods are normal and The investigations are normal, but my body doesn't feel right. And we just get stuck. Like we're not taught. We don't know what to do with that. And yet it is a critical time where we can move away from, you know, that disease diagnosis and help position us on that trajectory towards health. And so what do we do? I think I would love to just talk about four things. One, I would say we need to be paying attention to ourselves. We are too distracted. We're not paying attention to what our body is saying. And it all starts by us paying attention, paying attention to our emotions, paying attention to how we feel, paying attention to what is going on in our body and how it is functioning and how that might have moved away from what you would normally experience. And regardless of whether you fit into a disease category or not, those are important, so important, symptoms and signs and indications that something's started going wrong. And so don't underestimate that. And I think what's very, very important when you take information to a doctor is building that story of what's going wrong, you know, writing it down so you have it in front of you when you go to tell your story. But it all begins with us paying attention. Our body wants us to thrive and it is trying to communicate. If something is wrong upstream, it is trying to tell you in some way, whether it's a change of bowel habit or a persistent cough or that something is going wrong, and it's trying to get that information to us. So always pay attention. And then I think the other thing that's really important is that you need to trust yourself. You are the best person to know what your body usually operates as, and you are the best person to know when something feels like it's gone wrong. And the same for your kids. Like if you are representing your children, you as a mother know your child better than that doctor. And so I would encourage you always to trust your own voice and to not be diminished. And if you go into a consultation and you feel gaslighted or not listened to, or you know, somebody's not taking it seriously, then politely, you know, walk out, go to the reception and book in with another clinician. Like don't discredit, you know, what you're feeling or what you're sensing. Trust yourself in that and really you know, find clinicians and doctors that work with you. And it might be that it is just a matter of reassurance and, you know, within a setting where you have time, where that doctor could, you know, pinpoint some things that you could do in your lifestyle to help you recover, which is what I love doing. But anyway, so yes, paying attention, trusting yourself, finding a sympathetic listening clinician. And then I think in the midst of that, go back to basics of, you know, what your body needs to heal. And they are the most basic things. Get a really good night's sleep consistently. You know, change your diary, cancel your shifts. Like if your body isn't functioning properly, get your sleep first, prioritize it, turn off Netflix, get caffeine out of your diet, get a routine, stop watching screens at night. Just those basics of really, really try to get that 7.5 to 9 hours asleep so that you're feeling refreshed. So go back to the basics around sleep. Go back to the basics around nutrition. Eat real food. Eat a little bit less than you think you need if you don't have an eating disorder, that is, you know, and eat together. Those are the three basic principles that will radically change, you know, your experience of health. Eat real food. Probably should add, eat it from healthy soils where it's grown in healthy soils. You know, eat a little bit less than maybe you think and eat together. You know, connect to yourself, stop, listen, connect to others. Maybe you just are lonely and need some friendship and need some human interaction. You know, reconnect with your landscape. Nature is incredible healer and teacher. And then move, you know, you don't have to go to the gym, get out for a walk, get out for some fresh air, just, you know, move where you can. If you're wheelchair bound, you can still move your upper body, move your upper body, breathe deeply, smile, move those muscles that you can move, you know, just keeping it about those five things, you know, sleep, eat some real food, connect with yourself and other people, get moving. And then finally, just managing that stress. make some changes to get the stress out of your life. And I tell you, if you can make little tweaks in these foundations, if you find yourself on that trajectory towards sickness and disease, you can change it. Or if you have a disease and you're on medication, you can change the trajectory. Or if you're recovering from cancer, like lifestyle changes are so important in terms of stopping recurrence, alongside other medications if that's the route you choose. Like, don't underestimate the basics and that ability for you to maneuver your own body to feeling better. But it all starts, you know, by paying attention to the signs, knowing your body, trusting yourself, you know, building some of those foundations in your body. When things are going wrong, finding a clinician who will listen and work with you over a period of time. So I hope that helps. Anything, you know, any questions, any thoughts, just you can get in touch with me through my website or just send me an email. And I hope you have a great week, and subscribe to my channel if you like it. Yes, and have a great week, and I'll see you again another time. So I think that's it. Yes. Bye.